How you doing? This is Ryan from Airborne, and you're rocking out to Maximum Threshold. Go get a speed ticket.
Automatic defense procedures initiated.
What we've got here is...
Maximum voltage. Maximum power. Maximum carnage. This is Maximum Threshold. Call the show at...
440-709-4977.
Maximum Threshold. And here's your hosts, Dom.
It's unstable, but possibly worse.
He's actually quite smart. He just makes errors of judgment along the way.
Some threshold, you're on the air.
Hello, this is Dominic.
Yeah, what's going on, man?
It is Danny Knight from Chronoverse.
Nice. What's going on, man?
Just rushing around, trying to get online here with you.
Oh, I'm doing the same thing. I was having computer problems and everything already.
Man, every time I call somewhere, they always have a computer problem. I hate computers.
I hear you. Wish there was another way of doing this. But everything's running
telephone?
Through this, though. Just the way it is. So what's going
on,
man?
What's the fastest way to communicate besides the telephone?
Texting.
Tell a woman.
That's right.
What's up, public Marky Z?
Yeah, I got Marky Z on the line also.
Sweet.
What's up, man?
Was having a big glass of some Kahlua. Listen to Aldo Nova in the background. What's the last time you heard Aldo Nova? That's why I started the show off. I just got online here. So what's going
on? Dominic, I seen Aldo Nova with Rainbow back in the 80s.
With what?
Aldo Nova opened for Rainbow at the Spectrum in Philadelphia
man.
In 1986.
That'd have been a sick ass show.
It was, dude. It was badass. You looked like a fantasy.
Damn, I would have liked to seen that. Even just straight up Rainbow, but Aldo, you know, he's up there. And I don't know what the hell he's doing. I know he was talking about doing some more shows lately, and I think he's been doing some cowboy rodeo shit or something. That's a guy I gotta track down. He's a hard one to get a hold of, though. He's really
so what's
keeping
going on, Dominic? What's going on with you, man?
Nothing. I'm just running a little late with the show here. Like I said, I was having some problems with the internet. That
are you on the air now?
Yeah, I'm on now. I'm recording now. I just got on here. I just played the intro and came right down and played some All the Nova, and that's where I'm at now. And you called in.
Awesome.
So I know I missed another call earlier, but what can I do? I couldn't get online, so I couldn't even tell if I had a call.
Well, what do you want to do? You want us just to hold on for a few?
No, no, we're cool. We're rolling. We're on.
All right.
I ain't going to stop. Once I get going, we don't break for nothing.
Freight train.
That's right.
No stopping it.
So let's see. What else we got going over here? Just doing the radio show. And then other than that, I have my band that we're getting ready to do a show. We're doing a couple gigs with King's X. And it's going to be pretty cool. So...
Where are you located?
Outside of Cleveland.
Cool.
Yeah.
I want to get out that way pretty soon, you know.
The scene's starting to pick back up over here. It was dead here for about a good 10 years. It was once that new metal shit would not leave this area. And so all the bands were sounding the same, and it got pretty crappy. And then a lot of the clubs out here, they were closing down, and it was just a mess. But now it's starting to pick back up over here, which is a nice scene because we need it over here up on the North Coast.
Good.
For people who aren't familiar...
Cleveland. Hello, Cleveland. You know, like the Spinal Tap.
Hello.
But where's Toledo compared to Cleveland?
That's almost...
That was a big scene back in the day. I remember. I'm originally from Detroit.
Okay.
And I remember Toledo was happening big time.
That's about almost 3 hours away from here.
North?
West. Northwest.
Okay.
Yeah. We're like in between Erie and Toledo. We're like right in the middle. Where are you located at?
We're out of Philadelphia.
Oh, okay. Nice. How's the scene over there?
Scene is everywhere, you know. Everyone complains about their own hometown. It's That's always right. the same.
It's got to be like that everywhere.
You go out of your hometown and you're doing well.
So people aren't familiar with your band. You want to give them a little brief about you guys and, you know, where have you been? You're like a little bio or whatever?
Yeah, well, basically, my band's Crown of Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Crown of Earth. You can check it out at crownofearth.com. You know, Facebook, Crown of Earth, all that stuff. Twitter, everywhere, Chronoverse. But we're based out of Philadelphia, and we've been hacking away for about 5 years now, and you know, chipping away at the stone just like every other, you know, metal band around here. I mean, I don't know if there how many other bands come and go, but I think people are starting to recognize our name around, not just Philadelphia, but outside of Philadelphia. So that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
We released our debut album last year, more like a re-release, but it's, you know, it's still like a release. We kind of re-released it, and that's a self-titled album called Crown of Earth.
Mm-hmm.
And it's played everywhere, you know, every internet radio station around the world, basically.
Nice.
We hooked up with a cool promoter who's really helping us out. So we're starting to build a pretty decent name, you know, and some other, you know, industry professionals are looking at us now and just finally getting some recognition that we did, you know, we worked for.
Yeah. Now, does your music fit your the look of you guys? Because you like, because you the look of you guys look like you're like some really badass that you don't want to fuck with on the street. Is that how your music comes across as well?
Yeah, it's not, you know, walking through the park with pink daisies on. You know, it's aggressive, heavy.
Mm-hmm.
It sounds like classic metal, you know, with actual vocal singing, which I gotta say is the best because that's me. I'm the vocalist.
Mm-hmm.
And how many vocalists does it take to change a light bulb? Just one, and the world to revolve around it, you know?
Now, that's a good one. I haven't heard that one.
That's a guitar joke, but I just put it onto myself. So.
Well, you got to do that. So, since you're going to go down that road, which member of your band is most likely to end up with a post-op tranny on the road?
Post-op tranny?
Yeah, with small hands and a real little Adam's apple. See, I'm giving
the
options.
One.
Usually everybody throws a drummer or the bass player under the bus on that one.
Nah, I'm not going to. I'm staying out of that question, man. But we all know who it is. Next question.
And that was, that's a good one, though.
You know what I'm talking about, Marky?
Yeah, man, I do. I'm the bass player, but I can play more into space.
Oh, I, yeah.
I prefer that.
You got to watch out for them bass players, man.
I love bass. It's a whole different animal.
Do you have do you ever play a stand-up bass?
No, I never tried that.
My bass player, he just got one, and he was all psyched. He wanted to play, and he brought it into practice Thursday. And we just looked at him like, my God, what the? And it wasn't one of those great big ones. It was like a thin one. And I'm like,
yeah.
And it was, you know, the fretless and all that. I'm like, man, you got to play that on stage. Right. I said, you got to put a cape on.
I never messed with it, actually. It's got to be pretty cool to try it, you know?
It looks pretty cool. I mean, they're not real tall. But I think it either go over really good. The thing we were going to do is we're going to have the stand-up bass in the middle of the stage with the spotlight on it. And we're just going to let it sit there for a while and let people just wonder, why is there a stand-up bass in the middle of the stage? And all of a sudden, he's just going to walk over and start playing.
Yeah, I like that a lot. That's funny.
That's pretty.
And then, you know what? Have smoke start to billow out of it.
Oh, that'd be nice. It's real small, though. It's
and then blow it up.
He just paid he paid like $1,100 for this thing.
Okay, don't blow it up.
Nah,
that reminds me of that video from Faith No More. They blew up the piano at the end.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we got to get some fish and we'll throw it on the stage, too.
Goldfish.
So what band are you in, Dominic?
The band is called Morning Wagon.
Morning Wagon?
Yeah. And there's not a lot of big hype on them. But we just say that we're the sexiest unknown band out there. It's just a straight-up hard rock band.
So, where's the rest of our band members?
It doesn't matter. It's too much chaos when everybody gets on anyway. So.
Oh, I know. Like I said, it's a five-way marriage, dude.
That's right.
That's what it is. Got my personality to deal with, man.
Mm-hmm. So how long has your band been around?
We've been, most of the founding members have been together for 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's been a work in progress. Man. Always had, like, drummer issues and finally nailed our drummer issue down.
Yeah,
we got that down to Vinny Corrado. He's doing real well.
Mm-hmm. And the person
here with us the last 2 years.
Nice. And what kind of background did he come from to bring him in?
He likes the blast beat death metal. You know,
I gotcha.
1,000 beats per minute kind of stuff.
Oh, speaking of that, have you heard the new Dying Fetus?
No, but I think he's mentioned that before.
Oh my God, you got to listen to this. even if you're not into death metal, you got to listen to this drummer, man. He's sick as hell, man.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Oh, right. Vinny probably knows of him.
Oh,
yeah,
I'm sure.
You know, Marky, he's probably mentioned that name before. I know he did.
Dude, Vinny is all about Black Dahlia. He can play like that drummer.
Oh my God,
Black Dahlia Murder.
That's his
thing.
That's a heavy ass band right there.
So he brings that kind of listen. He brings that kind of aggression and then like speed mm-hmm. to his playing, to our material.
Yeah,
which are a lot of our stuff is kind of a Sabbath-y and Iron Maiden.
Yeah,
and Judas Priest, and then he brings this fast aggression to it, and it kind of blends well. So we can we can run the gamut, you know. It's good that you got a drummer that can do technical stuff, but and basic stuff. But if you only got a drummer that can do, you know, basic stuff,
yeah,
you're limited.
Oh,
so
yeah.
we can run the gamut, you know.
And we have like
what
our
do.
Yeah. We can play everything.
Yeah, I know
dynamics.
I understand that thoroughly because we have our bass player. We start talking, you got to hit these notes, and me and other guitarists, we just look at him like, "What the fuck are you talking about?" He said, "You got to do. We're in this key. I have no clue what you're talking about. We'll just play it by ear." But it's cool. You got somebody who knows, yeah, when you got somebody who knows structure and, you know, the details, that it helps keep, it could act like it's the ringleader of the band in sort of a way, like piecing together a good song.
Benny's a good piece. Yeah. Let me tell you, he's a godsend, really. He fits in like really good. Even though he brings that newer style metal,
yeah,
it fits and brings us to the next level and then some.
Oh, that's cool. Now, was he part of the recording of the latest release that you have out?
No,
actually, no. He had another drummer at the time that one of the beginning members, and then he took his place.
Okay.
Well, he took a number of drummers' places.
I was not on the CD as well. I actually came into the band after the CD was already done and recorded, and I learned the material because I really loved it. I loved the classic metal sound that, you know, the industry's missing this.
Oh, yeah, I agree.
And we're the band that is going to bring it back because we are veterans, we're seasoned musicians, and we can make that happen.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what made me be attracted to this band. When I started learning their material, when they told me, do you want to play bass for the band? I said, let me check your stuff out. I started learning one song each day. Next thing you know it, I got like five songs. I go audition for these guys. I got five songs under my belt. I play them one after the next. The next thing Mike says to me, Mark, do you want to be a bass player for this band? Because our other bassist, he's great, but he can't commit to the band.
Mm-hmm.
I said, well, why the fuck do you think I'm here?
Yeah. I know how it is, man, because mine was basically the same way. But I used this role as like, man, you guys, you know what really make your band sound really good? If you had another guitarist in there, then it'll make your whole sound really full.
Yeah.
That's how I got in the band.
Sure.
Got a weasel.
Well, I love playing with these guys. The best band I've ever been in, and I've been in a lot of bands in my life, let me tell you.
Any bands that... Was there any bands that actually made it or anything like that? Or close to it?
That I was in?
Yeah.
Involved?
Yeah.
Well, I guess you could say my rock hip-hop band, Mixed Match Sox, was signed back in 2004 in Star Power Entertainment.
Okay.
Unfortunately, my manager is dead. Mm-hmm. Producer Buddy Turner, God rest his soul. And I tried the hip-hop thing for 5 years. You know, just to try to, you know, basically, you know, do something different.
Yeah.
You know, try to be versatile. You know, the name of the game in this business is versatility.
Oh, I understand that.
Be able to play everything, a little bit of everything. That's the way to do it.
Yep.
You know? And that's, you know, I'm not afraid to go step out the box, you know? Mm-hmm. And I did that. It was fun. You know, but yes, we got signed. I was on BMI as an artist. You know, it just didn't go as far as I would have liked it to have gone. But it was a great experience, I have to say.
Now, is this band that you're in now, is this Crown of Earth, are you hitting the road? Are you doing any tours or anything like that?
Yeah, Danny, we're actually, you know, starting to branch out outside of Philadelphia, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And
we got a show coming up.
The decent show coming up is with Blaze Bailey from Wolfsbane / Iron Maiden.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's right in New York City, what is it? The Bronx? No, not the Bronx.
Brooklyn. St. Vitus is the name of the venue.
Yeah, but where's that? Where is that again?
It's in Brooklyn, Danny.
Right, Brooklyn. I always get that screwed up.
Yeah. Well, you know how that happened, Danny. Tell them. You know, like, we played Lucky 13 for our very first time going and playing in New York, and we killed it. And the next thing, they invited us to play Brooklyn again, and this time they put us in even a bigger club.
Nice.
So that was, like, pretty cool, I have to say.
When is that show? Because I could send a couple of our guys. We have people who work out there and do our show with us are out in New York, New Jersey.
Let me look it up real quick. It's August.
It's Thursday, August 10th, Dominic.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. There you go.
You got to write that down.
Thursday, August 10th with Blaze Bailey. Check out our Facebook page. I mean, I put it on there, you know. Check out Armageddon Productions. That's Ed Farsi. I'm not sure how to pronounce his name, but he's a really great, great dude. He had some kind of webzine back in the 80s. Like, him and his buddy put together an actual paper you know, they drew the pictures and they interviewed a bunch of bands like up in Lemoore's and everything, and he just became a pretty cool.
What's his name again?
Ed Farsi.
It sounds he sounds familiar. Is he in cahoots with that guy from Piercing Metal?
You know, I don't know, but just check him out. Check out Armageddon Productions. He's got a bunch of great shows that he puts together, and he I love this guy because he knows how to line up a show. He doesn't put like some hip hop band with a friggin', you know, classic metal band with a death metal band. With opening up with a rockabilly band. I mean, he just puts all the kick-ass bands together like they should be, you know?
Nice.
So he really knows his stuff.
I understand that.
Armageddon Productions, I believe it is. Armageddon 1 or something like that. I'll let you know in a second. I'm going to go on there and write my stuff. I'm looking at your page, MaximumThreshold.net. That's pretty cool, dude.
You like that? That thing's
good. Yeah, I like... Marky was just talking about dead daisies or something on the way here.
Some cool dudes, man.
I saw that on your page. Dead daisies.
Yeah, I'm about after tonight on tomorrow when I get it back on the website. There, I'm going to really put a thing up there about your band and all that. And you know, I've been playing your music over here. It's been on our network all day, and
awesome.
I've been playing in the background since you've been talking. I don't know if you could hear it, but. I got your music playing back here, too, so I'm going to tag the hell out of it, and we'll do what we can do to help and get the word out there for you guys.
Yeah, man, we appreciate, you know, guys like you, definitely, that keep metal alive. It's an honor, you know, to work with you.
I know what I want to talk to you about. Who helped produce your record?
A good friend of mine, man. I've known for many moons. His name's Richard Gavalis. About 45 minutes away, he's got a studio called Dome Sound, and it's actually a really cool place. It's almost like a dungeon.
Oh wow!
I mean, literally, it looks like a dungeon when you walk down this sloping hill and you walk through the front door, and it looks like you're entering another world. But it's a geodesic dome that they built back in the 70s. I think some big producer named David Ivory and some of his teammates built this studio in this old warehouse that used to build flags for America, or I don't know, for the war or something. This warehouse, it's got a lot of history in it. They took the space, built this geodesic dome out of horsehair, newspaper, and like glue or something. And it's when you walk into the cutting room, it's this huge dome, like a half of a dome. And you can go in anywhere of the room, and you can get complete isolation. Just all the band instruments are in the room, and you can get isolation from just not even being in separate rooms. You know what I mean? It's amazing. And it's just awesome space. And so basically we recorded there the Crown of Earth album. And he's done, you know, he's got gold and platinum and multi-platinum credits to his name by doing... a lot of bands from England and stuff like the Bloodhound Gang, which is right around his neighborhood, you know. So he got fame from the Bloodhound Gang, and he just knows his stuff. He's like a mad scientist, and he's great friends.
Nice.
Richard Gavalis over at Dome Sound Studio. So I like plugging him because we always hit him over the head and kind of rape him for the fee.
I hear you.
He's a friend, we take advantage of him.
He did a great
work. He engineered, you know, engineered it, edited it, mixed it, produced it, recorded it, mastered it. You know, he did everything. So, if you ever need any kind of mastering, you know, nowadays you can send your files to anybody and they can do it. So he's great at mastering, and he's real quick. You know, instead of trying to do it yourself in your bedroom, you send it to him, and he'll get you a radio-ready mastering job. You know what I mean?
Definitely, man. Bands need that. Because so many bands are doing that out of their basement and just doing the recording and doing their self and just putting it out there. And they're missing the whole production of having a professional come in and take a different look at and a different view of the music and, you know, orchestrate it the right way. Way music should be put together. that you takes you out of the box.
I talked about it with him, and it's actually more cost effective. I mean, if you think about the learning curve somebody has to do to get to a awesome production level, it takes a long time, you know. And if you pay him a measly fee, mm-hmm. you can have your songs radio ready in no time, you know, mm-hmm. instead of having to go through that hassle of trying to learn how to do it.
Yeah.
It's nice to know how to do it, you know. I kind of do that because I'm cheap.
No, I know.
I want to do everything myself.
Yeah. I hear you.
But I've learned just through him that sometimes it pays to just get it done and over with, you know.
I got a question for you. What's your formula of trying to get your music out to the masses?
Well, I think we're kind of finally realizing that doing the old school beating the pavement, mm-hmm. You know, playing all the local shows you can in the world, which has helped, you know. It's like anybody I talk to locally, oh, you're in Chronoverse? Everybody has heard of our name, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then you got Facebook, and they put on their on the event page going.
They don't show
going
up.
And then you go to the show.
There's four people.
And there's like minimal people there. So it's misleading, mm-hmm. and it's weird, you know. To me, I just the last interview I did, I thought of some great scheme. I should act on it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's you know, it takes time and money and energy, and I don't have any of those.
What's the plan?
Well, we got a guy out of Southern California that's mm-hmm. pretty cool, man. He's a good guy, and he does his homework, and he's very much a go-getter. He's got a company out there that promotes us. Probably how how we got in contact with each other, because okay. I don't think I would have been able to contact you. I mean, there's a lot of he's got a lot of resources under his belt,
mm-hmm.
and you know, we work with online metal promo. That's I'll just throw the plug out there.
I gotcha.
So all you bands that want to get your name circulating, check out Benjamin at Online Metal Promo.
He works hard, man. He's very persistent. That's a good thing. You need these people like that.
I know, he pisses me off a lot, but I love him.
Because there's a lot of these weird publicists that are popping up here and there short term. You know, they'll come in here, they'll tell you their deal, and they'll get your money from you, and you won't hear shit from them about what they're doing. But people like this guy, man, and a bunch of other ones that, you know, they get in details, and they really got to want to make things happen for the band.
Yeah, he's real quick about it. He gets results. I heard about him many years ago. And I just wasn't ready.
Yeah.
My band wasn't in the position to do any kind of promo.
Mm-hmm.
But I heard about him, and I kind of just, you know, just put it on the back burner with him. And then recently we saw an ad from a good friend of ours that has a television, like an online television. He wants to bring back an MTV-style video show, you know.
Yeah.
And that's his goal, but it's called Rock Titan Television, mm-hmm. Scotty. He actually, you know, we worked with him a long time, and I saw Online Metal Promo on his ad or something, or some page of his, or like a link. I'm like, what the hell is this? Let's check it out. And then I realized it was Benjamin from many years ago, but that's why we started working with him, because he's been around a long time, and it's good.
Nice. Yeah, with the people that work for you, man, and they make, and you see progress, man. You got to stick with them, because the dividends will pay off down the road.
Yeah, yeah, that's why we, you know, sticking with him, he's a good guy, and he gets things done. That's what we need, and we're in the position to get things done right now. I mean, and Marky, he's been working his ass off, right, Marky? He's got a lot of things lining up.
I got some good things in the works. I don't want to announce quite yet.
Yeah, I mean, we're really talking to some good industry professionals right now, mm-hmm. so I think now's our time. It's now or never, you know.
Oh, I hear you.
So
yeah, don't let that don't let it pass you by.
No, we ain't got time to let it pass.
I hear you. Yeah, 'cause you only live so long, you know. Then and it's all over with. Because once you start getting in the 50s and you start getting that carpal tunnel and the arthritis starts kicking in, man, it's all downhill. I'm telling you. Diabetes kicks in and all that. Oh, man, it's a bitch. I'm telling you.
Yeah, well, I'm a cyborg, so it doesn't really matter for me, but my programming is only, it's like 2K, I think. I think I was going to go out on 2K, Y2K, but I somehow managed to reprogram myself, so I'm still functioning.
So you got the artificial intelligence going on there.
Yeah, it's pretty dumb.
Let's hear just a couple more things here, and we'll let you guys get going. But once again, man, how can people get a hold of your music?
Let's see. First of all, crownofearth.net, mm-hmm. .com. I'm thinking of my buddy's, domesound.net, domesoundstudio.net. That's for the recording.
Okay.
Then you got maximumthreshold.net. That's what I'm looking at right now.
That's right.
But my band, Crown of Earth,
mm-hmm.
crownofearth.com. Also Twitter, you know, just do a Google search for, Google search. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Google search. Dude, I'm cracking myself up over here.
You're doing a good job.
I don't know why. Because Google, first of all, is the stupidest name in the world, but it's the biggest thing ever. But anyway, do a Google search, Crown of Earth Band, and we'll pop up. You can Facebook, of course. You know, that we usually keep up more with the Facebook.
Yeah.
But, you know, more shows are up to date on there. It sucks working on a website, you know.
Oh, I know that.
Until we get this big conglomerate team behind you to do all the functions.
Mm-hmm.
So, but you know, the basic, all the average stuff, you know, all the typical stuff.
Hey Dominic, I got a question for you.
Yeah.
How could we tag you on Twitter? This way we can keep in touch and we can do some promotional for everybody. You know?
Okay, we're on Twitter. We're at Max Threshold, or you can get me at MT Dom. Pretty simple.
Thank you.
So it's Max Threshold or MT Dom. Either one, they come right to my phone, and I could keep it going.
So Max Threshold or what's the other one?
MT Dom.
MC?
MT, like maximum MT. Threshold. So it'd be like MT.
Oh, duh.
Dom.
Yeah, letter M.
Dom as in Dominic.
Yeah.
And that's at or pound, I mean.
Oh, no, that's at MT. That's on Twitter.
Yeah, okay.
MT Dom. I'll follow you guys on Instagram and all that. I'll put all your links up there as well. I'll tag the hell out of you guys. We'll get it out there.
Appreciate that, man.
No problem.
But yeah, this is really cool, dude. Thank you so much for having us on here.
What song do you want me to play off your latest release?
Maybe Power Minds, I think. That's pretty cool.
Oh, got it right
here. You know, Why Should I Care? Actually, we're going to do a video for that.
Okay.
We're preparing a warehouse stage setup for like the, we're going to do like the live footage scenes at this really cool warehouse that this guy used to do production for Poison and everybody. He's got all the light show stuff in his warehouse, and we're the band goes over there once in a while, and we set it up. So we're going to do the video Why Should I Care? So if you want to put that on, I like Frank. Frank's my favorite song, Frank mm-hmm. the Hellraiser. Mm-hmm. And then Why Should I Care is the video.
Okay.
We also got a video out there for the veterans. I got to mention that because we always do like charity work and we support our veterans. So the song called Born Again Warrior is dedicated to the troops. That song they seem to like and it's dedicated to them because it just happened to come out that way just from the title alone. It's called Born Again Warrior.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, if you look at the video, it's kind of like about say a veteran goes overseas, they come home, they need a new arm or a new leg. With modern medicine, they can get that option.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, they become born-again warriors. So that's what that's about. So we have a video out there on YouTube also. It's got 150,000 views at the moment.
Oh, damn, that's pretty good.
For that Born Again Warrior video. Check that out on YouTube. So anyway, crownofearth.com will lead you over to everything. CDs, you can purchase the CD off the website digital downloads off of CD Baby and iTunes and all that crap.
Nice.
So it's whatever. You just go to the website, browse around, and see what fits you. We got T-shirts, you know, from the album cover. It looks really cool. It's called the Apocalypse Rider. We hired this artist to commission this badass image of the Apocalypse Rider.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's just everything's in place, you know, like it's supposed to be.
Nice. Definitely. I'm going to check it all out and everything. And I'm looking forward to really diving into your music. And, you know, because once you really get me to sucked into it, man, I'm all out. You know, I'm doing everything I can do, man.
Cool. Awesome, man. Thank you so much.
Oh, no problem.
Thomas.
Hey, can you do us a quick favor? Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah, it was breaking up a little bit.
Oh. Can you do a promo ID for our radio show? Just say your name, the band you're with, you're listening to Maximum Threshold.
All right.
Hey, what's up?
Wait a second. Our conference call line.
You guys got to hang up or something.
Thank you for tuning in.
Hold on, Dominic.
Sure. Yeah, I want to thank everybody. Yeah. Got my baby to my left. Yeah. Got the smooth sounds. I hear a Maximum Threshold radio. Yeah. Ooh, can you feel it? Got the mandingo on the rise. Ooh, baby.
Dominic, are you there?
Yeah, I'm singing along to the music.
Somebody hung up our conference call line. Oh. And I'm the only one on the conference call at this point.
That's all right.
So it gives the music on hold.
That's
all
right,
man.
I'm
the whole conference is joined.
I was breaking it down, man. I was doing my Barry White talk in the back. Do you hear the music?
You gotta mute us. We can't have elevator music playing on Maximum Threshold. You know what I mean?
Can you hear it? Can you hear the music?
I hear Maximum Threshold. I mean, I hear the elevator music from On Hold.
Oh, I'm rocking to that. Oh yeah.
Breaking. Are you hearing? Down. Can you hear that?
Yeah, I can hear it. Sounds good. Ooh.
It sounds good.
I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in to this night's edition.
I'm going to call you right back, dude. Tell me right.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Sounds good.
We'll call you right back.
Okay.
Ralph and Mark.
Yeah. Thank you for listening to the wonderful tunes here on Maximum Threshold Radio. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in this week's edition of the Maximum Threshold Radio Show, episode 497. And we got Crown of Earth that's been on the phone here since we went live over a half hour ago. So I want to thank you for tuning in to this week's edition. And I just want to say, man, we're going to be rocking it out the rest of the night here. I got another interview coming up here in a little bit. But once again, I want to thank you again for being here with us. And let me put their music on so you guys can check out who you're talking to. This is Crown of Earth. Why Should I Care? Exclusively here on your Maximum Threshold Radio. I want to thank Curtis for tuning in tonight, too. Just text me saying, man, he's listening to this and he's loving it. Yo.
Hey.
What's going on? Hey, I got a question for you. I was in this Why Should I Care song. What Metallica song is that riff coming from? Which
what,
one? Did,
Marky, what Metallica song is the maximum, I mean, Why Should I Care riff coming from?
Go, dun,
I don't hear Metallica dun, 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 in it, but I don't think it's coming from Metallica. Dun, 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 dun. No, he's not saying that. He hears
I hear Metallica song.
Yeah, I hear part of it.
But again, anybody can hear anything and anything. You know what I mean? I don't hear it.
I'm not saying it's a bad thing, because that's what caught my attention and made me turn it up louder. So I'm not saying it was a bad thing.
He likes it, though. Yeah.
It sounded like
I know what you're saying, man.
It's that Ride the Lightning era kind of vibe to this sound, which is pretty cool.
Well, it's like our dynamic song. It's the girl meets boy, girl dumps boy, boy doesn't give a crap. That's what it's about.
Yeah. Here, listen to that riff. Well, not that part, but dun, 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 dun. Right there. Then you went, dun, dun, or is it Iron Maiden, I'm thinking?
Maybe it's Maiden. I hear the Iron Maiden in that part. Yeah, I definitely hear it. I think it's like Still Life or something.
Yeah, I know it's...
No.
Murders in Revelations.
Remember that song Revelations by Iron Maiden?
Yeah.
You know, I tell that to my... If I hear like a resembling... something that resembles a part of another song, I tell the guy who wrote it.
Yeah.
I say, that sounds just like so and so. He's like, I never heard that song. So
that's funny.
He'll plead the fifth every time. That's our guitar player.
But that's cool. Well, I like that when I'm able to associate something with your music. And then now when I hear Iron Maiden again, I'm going to think of, man, there's a song that is band, man. It has that vibe to it. You got to check this out. It's a good thing. It's a positive thing.
Good, good. Now again, like it's just melodic, you know, and musical rather than, you know, trying not to make too much noise.
I hear you. Okay, you want to do that promo ID for us?
Yeah, you ready for it?
Go for it.
Hey, everybody, this is Danny Knight from Crown of Earth. Jamming out with you on Maximum Threshold Radio.
That was perfect. Hey, man, I definitely thank you again for calling in and being on the show tonight. And like I said, I'm going to do everything we can on our part to help get the word out there and do what we could do for you.
Dude, I appreciate that a lot, man. Thank you.
And we got a lot of connections, like out in Cali as well. And like I said, we have some staffers over there in New York, in New Jersey area, man. Now I'll throw the word out there about the Blaze show, and because I know they were talking about going to that as it is. So if they go out there, man, I'll have them hook up with you guys there.
Yeah, tell them to knock on our door. You know what I mean?
Nice, I'll do that. But definitely,
all right, Dominic. Appreciate all your help, dude.
No problem, man.
We'll keep rocking out with Maximum Threshold.
Sounds good, man. Thanks.
All right, brother. I'll talk to you soon.
Take care, man.
Bye. Bye.
It's contest time. Text message the show at 440-252-0058. Once again, that text message number is 440-252-0058. First one text wins whatever the hell we're giving away. Thanks for listening to Maximum Threshold Radio.
You want to follow Maximum Threshold Radio? You can do so. You can find us at MaximumThreshold.net, Facebook, Facebook.com/Maximum Threshold Radio, Twitter at Max Threshold. You can also get us on YouTube at YouTube.com/Maximum Threshold. Pretty damn simple, huh? Check us out. Follow us. Be part of us.
Missed the live show? Go to StitcherRadio.com and search Maximum Threshold and listen in today. That's Maximum Threshold and Stitcher Radio, a match made in heaven.
Now back to Maximum Threshold. Man, these guys are hotter than a two-bit hooker.
That's right, man. Going on out there. Hey, I want to thank everybody for tuning in this week's edition of the Maximum Threshold Radio Show. We just happened to have the guy, we just had the guys on from Crown of Earth on the show, man. Check them out, man. Crownofearth.com. They're on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Go follow them. I'm going to put all the links up on the website. We're going to tag it all in with the show tonight. But yeah, great guys, man. Check them out. And also, if you're out there in the Brooklyn area out there in August, when Blaze Bailey comes through the town, go check them out, man. I know they're going to bring it. So if you see them, you go to the show, check them out. Tell them you heard about them here on Maximum Threshold Radio. And don't pickpocket them, man, because they got a long drive back home. Okay. Just toss them your sister or something. Okay. Look, I'm going to get back to the music over here. And hey, I want to thank everybody for tuning in. And we did start a little late. I had some problems with the internet and with the, should be more, I should say the server was down and it wasn't even our fault. So just want to toss it out there. So here, I'll be back after this here on Maximum Threshold Radio. I'll play some music for you, man. I want you guys just to relax, man. Take your shoes off, put your hand on your pants and listen to some Melachia.
Time to pull out your hairy ching-chings.
That's right.
All right, Kukui, hang on to you some red horns.
Other, and that's all.
right. That's Metalachi for you with Living on a Prayer in the Barrio. okay, I got another song here. Then we're coming back in. Who knows what's up next?
What's up? This is Satchel from one of the greatest heavy metal bands of all time, Steel Panther. And you're listening to Maximum Threshold with Dom.
Yes, you are. Sean Hooker.
You're listening to Maximum Threshold Radio. I just came from outer space.
Our request on MaximumThreshold.net.
Here's some Ravage with Turn the Screw here on Maximum Threshold Radio. Horns up, fist in the air, baby.
Sure, what you believe.
Maximum Threshold. You're on the air.
Hey, man, it's Al from the band Rat.
What's going on, man? I'm just playing your music right now, playing Turn the Screw.
I heard.
Damn,
heard
it's...
I called it.
It scared me, man, because you're coming out of the solo, and you start talking, and it sounded like somebody was behind me talking to me. I'm like, what the fuck? I had to turn around, I got scared. No shit, man. Cause I was really listening deep in the song. I had turned up and everything.
Yeah, that's the point of the song.
Oh, yeah. So, so what's going on?
Not too much. Not too much.
Oh, man. I've just got a chance to really start listening to your music and diving into this, and I'm digging this, man. This is some good stuff.
Well, thanks, man. Checking it out. Thanks for having us on the show.
Nice. So people who aren't familiar with your band, Ravage, you want to give them a little brief about your band? And, you know, I know you guys have been around for years, but for people, like I said, who aren't familiar with it, just give them a brief about it.
Yeah, we've been around for a long time, but not too many people actually know about us. Mm-hmm. Kind of it's below a cult band, but we're underground.
Yeah.
Still underground. We formed in the mid-90s as a high school band, or even before high school, I guess. And we just kept the band together in different forms and recorded a bunch of demos and stuff. But we never had a real good recording until about 2003.
Mm-hmm.
We put out a 6-song EP called Curse of Heaven.
Okay.
Which, got us some recognition overseas in Europe. And then we got signed to a German record label around that time. So in the mid-2000s, we put out our first full-length album, which is called Spectral Rider. And that was pretty cool. We got to play overseas a little bit, but still didn't get a lot of recognition over here.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, we kept playing and recording and stuff. And then finally in 2009, we got signed to Metal Blade Records.
Oh, nice.
So that was cool. You know, people know Metal Blade Records.
That's yeah.
People have actually heard of. But we were probably one of the least selling albums in Metal Blade history.
Ain't that a bitch, man? God, that sucks. That sucks, man, doesn't it?
It was a cool experience.
Yeah, but you could. But the whole thing is like, you're like, yeah, man. I'm with. Did you, when you sign that deal with them, you're like, fuck yeah, man, Metal Blade. And it doesn't really pan out. That's got to like really piss you off, doesn't it?
No. Actually, I mean, it was just a cool thing to happen.
I mean, oh yeah, I agree with you.
It wasn't one of those things where it was like, you know, so close and yet so far. It was more like, wow, can't believe this happened. Mm-hmm. And it happened, and then it was over.
Now, did they come to you, or did you go to them? Did you toss your music to them?
They came to us totally out of the blue.
Oh, wow.
We were afraid to put out the album ourselves because we didn't have any label interest at all.
Mm-hmm.
Not even from the label we were on before. They didn't like the recording that we played for them. They're saying, well, you know, we like some of the songs, but, you know, it's not quite in the style of the last recording.
Yeah.
And we don't like the production. It sounds too modern and stuff. So we're like, oh, well, I guess we're going to put it out ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got an email from Metal Blade Records out of the blue, and they're like, well, we want to put the album out.
Wow.
Cool.
Yeah, this, when I was listening to this, man, all I can think of is, if you close your eyes, listen to it, you can think of it as being like that Sad Wings of Destiny kind of vibe, the old Priest kind of sound to it.
Well, that's what we're going for, man. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the pinnacle.
Yeah.
That's what everybody should be going for.
That's so, right.
Yeah,
and it's good, man.
Then after Sin, Sad Wings of Destiny, those are huge influences. So, you know, we're just trying to put out something that can be, you know, put next to that and not be a total embarrassment.
Yep.
So.
You did a good job, man.
Well, thanks, man.
So what's the plan now to get the music out there to the people?
Well, this is the first time we're actually putting a full length out ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Without a record label. So we finally got there. You know, nobody's interested. But we're putting it out ourselves. We're just appearing on shows such as yours, mm-hmm. and wherever we can to try to promote it. And then hopefully we'll be able to play some shows and try to get on some festivals and stuff in the coming year or so.
I could definitely picture you guys going on playing Vakken or something like that, man. Get on one of those stages over there and play. Music fits in perfect with that kind of vibe.
Yeah, man, we'd like to. We'd love to. If you book it, we will come.
Well, what I'll do is I'll look and see. I got a couple labels that I deal with. I'll toss them your way, and maybe you can see what you could do with them.
Sure.
See if that works.
What's nice is we have our own studio set up now. That's where we're able to record this. And so we're going to start recording the new album of all new material. Hoping to get that out, through somebody. Mm-hmm. So, any help would be appreciated.
Gotcha.
But for now, we're just trying to push this. And while we're getting plans to record the next one.
Nice. Now, are you going to be working? Now, who would be like, are you going to be doing a self recording? Or are you going to go into somebody else's studio to do this?
Well, what was cool about this is that my brother Eli, who's the guitarist in the band,
mm-hmm.
He had started recording some local bands. Like his band, CX, is an up-and-coming speed metal band.
Okay.
And he recorded their album. And so we were like, well, we've got our own recording setup now. We might as well, test it out by recording this album that we had put out in Europe a few years ago, over 10 years ago now.
Mm-hmm.
So we re-recorded that because we never liked the production on that. And so now we know that we can do it. Pretty much we're going to record our stuff, the stuff ourselves, and maybe get some mixing and mastering help, but we can pretty much record everything ourselves.
Nice. So you guys did the re-recording of this Return of this on the Spectral Rider. You did that yourself?
Yep, we record the whole thing ourselves. In this basement setup that we've got.
Damn, it sounds good.
And then we had... straight from the basement, man.
I'm really impressed, man. That sounds good.
And we had Peter Ruccio, who was the producer and mixer of the last album.
Mm-hmm.
He actually mastered it. But aside from that, we did everything. We got all the recording and all the mixing ourselves.
Nice. So what type of shows you got? You have any shows coming up or anything that we could help pimp for you?
We actually, strangely enough, we don't have any shows this summer. Our mm-hmm. next show is coming up in September. So we're just kind of hanging out and recording and stuff and writing for the summer, I guess.
Gotcha.
But we do have a show with Blood Feast, the thrash band from New Jersey, coming up in September. And that should be pretty cool.
And are you playing in Jersey?
No, they're actually coming up here to Massachusetts. We're going to be playing in Worcester, Massachusetts with them at a place called Ralph's Diner. And that should be a pretty cool show.
Nice. Well, I'll definitely put that up on our site. We'll make it like a little sponsor thing on the side of the website for you.
That would be awesome.
Get some word out there. So what else you guys got in the mix?
Well, we're going to be working on some music videos, maybe,
mm-hmm.
and some behind-the-scenes kind of videos about the making of it and, explaining the lyrics and stuff. We're going to be putting together our own videos just to promote, and hopefully a couple of music videos we'll be, working on, some professional-looking music videos.
Mm-hmm.
And just going from there until the next shows or shows come up, just trying to get on whatever we can, any festivals and live shows that we can to promote it.
Gotcha. When you guys were putting together the lyric video to Turn the Screw, did you guys do that yourself, or did you have somebody else do that for you?
Yeah, we did it ourselves.
How'd you do that? What program did you use?
Sorry?
What program did you use to do that?
I just did it on my Mac, whatever the video editing software is on the Mac. The name escapes me, but it's just the Mac video editing software. It's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Just took the album art and threw some lyrics on it, And gotcha. That's the lyric video. So nothing too elaborate. And maybe hopefully the next video will be a little more professional, mm-hmm. and maybe feature the band in it, but hopefully not. You know, we're not the most video friendly guys in the world, mm-hmm. the most photogenic. So
when you first started the band, what were the goals? Being a kid putting the band together, well, I want to hear what your dreams were for the band.
When we started out, you know, we wanted to be. Well, I should say when we started out. It was the mid-90s,
mm-hmm.
so metal was the furthest thing from cool.
Yeah,
I mean, like, I remember going into record stores and you could not find an Iron Maiden record.
Yep.
You could not find a Judas Priest CD. And I would, like, I would look it up on this computer and you couldn't even, the stuff was out of print. It was crazy back
wow.
then. It was just not cool. So what we wanted to do at that point was, you know, kill grunge.
Yep.
And alternative music, and bring, you know, like Iron Maiden and heavy metal back to the masses, mm-hmm. mediums, and be big rock stars.
Yep.
And just shove that down everybody's throat.
Did you draw?
It didn't really turn out though.
Did you guys draw like stage sets? How you wanted to look like?
Oh man, you wouldn't believe it. In the early days, we actually tried to have a stage show.
Oh yeah.
There's a video somewhere of us where we've got like guys dressed up as skeletons and devils. And smoke machines and paper mache creatures.
Oh, that's cool.
I remember we had like a big dragon paper mache bass drum head.
You still have that? You still have that video of that?
There's a video somewhere. I gotta dig it out.
Oh yeah, you gotta get that and make a new lyric video and use that as the background.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I think I will.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Yeah, we wanted to be like Wasp or something in the early days, or Iron Maiden. So we totally went with the whole trying to do the stage show thing, but it didn't really pan well.
I remember when I was a kid, when I wanted to put together a band, my first band name was called Izzy Evil. So I had the stage all set up, and it was supposed to be like three times better than any Kiss show. So we had like fire and all kind of stuff. We had this all drawn out. We made like these little prototype stages and everything that we were going to put together. You know, of course, it didn't work out, but it was just the idea of that, of you know, your dreams is when you're a kid, like 11 and 12, putting together one of the baddest bands in the world. And one of our goals was we wanted to sell millions of records. And the way we were going to do it was on our record, we were going to have. Like one song would be metal, one song would be country, one song would be polka. So we'd have everything. So we'd have the whole gambit covered, and we'd also do a Christmas record too.
That's awesome.
It never worked out.
Look, I think actually, well, I mean, the big bands had those ideas too.
Yeah.
I mean, Iron Maiden started doing their show in clubs.
Yeah.
Motley Crue originally tried to call themselves Christmas because they thought that would be appealing.
So I got a question. Where'd you find the guys in your band? Because you kept this band. This has this lineup been the same over the decades?
No.
Yeah.
Well, luckily, three guys from the band, the two guitarists and myself,
mm-hmm.
Have been together for about 17 years now.
Oh wow.
One of them is my brother, so that's either, you know, some brothers stick together,
right.
You know, fly apart. But that's kind of kept us together, that we had a mutual interest in the same kind of music.
Yeah.
The other guitarist, Nick, has been with us forever, you know, since around 2001.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what's kept the band together, because we're the main songwriters in the band.
Yeah.
And then we just had a revolving door rhythm section for 20 years. You know, just different drummers every couple of years, different bassists.
They always have personal issues? Is that the problem? Wives, girlfriends?
No, nothing too dramatic. It's just, and we always got along great with everybody.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, for one reason or another, people would leave. Like our last drummer, who played on the last, you know, tour that we did, he wanted to play constantly. He wanted to be touring all the time.
Yeah.
So he ended up joining a band. He just kind of left us out of the blue and was like, "Hey guys, I got this offer from this band out in Colorado, and I'm going to go join those guys." And he joined the band Havoc, and they've been touring ever since, doing really well. I mean, they even opened for Megadeth and stuff.
Yeah, they got a new one just came out, too.
Yep, Conformicide. Yep.
Weren't they? They're doing some shows with Suicidal, weren't they?
Yeah, I think they're on tour right now. They're not coming to Massachusetts for some reason, but they're going everywhere else in the world.
Yeah, I was talking to those guys. I don't remember who it was in the band. This was a few months ago about them when they were coming through the Cleveland area. We were going to hook up and talk about the new record because I know they stopped playing for a bit. They were doing something with Madball or something like that.
Yeah, I mean, they're constantly on tour, constantly. They're in that, like, recording, touring cycle, and that's just what they do.
Yeah.
And it's incredible. Their drummer, Pete, he drummed on our tour, and then he just basically went right into that. We were about to start writing and you know, recording new songs and stuff, and he was like, guys, I just want to be, you know, constantly playing, so he took off. Wow. And right now, he's like one of the top five drummers in metal.
That's pretty sweet, man. Yeah, tell you.
Yeah,
tell them when they get a little bigger, they need to pull you guys on the road with them.
It'd be nice, you know. Yeah. It's funny, you know, people just kind of move on from the band. We actually, the drummer on our 2005 album, Spectral Rider, he went on to band Revocation.
Oh, okay.
And they're also very well known. So.
What happened to you guys? Like what's going on to you guys? You guys need your break, man. Not the members. You guys, your band, let's do it.
We've been broken many times.
How can people get a hold of your music?
Well, we're on all the social media websites. Our main site is ravagetheearth.com, which, as websites are now, is just kind of a portal to YouTube and Facebook and Twitter and all the other stuff. So we've got a Facebook, which is Facebook/RavageTheEarth, RavageTheEarth.com, and you can find our videos on YouTube and you know, Bandcamp, CD Baby, and all the rest. So go check them out.
Which one of those actually helps you guys sell more releases on there?
It's hard to say. You know, however people consume the music is cool with me. We've got CDs, we've got vinyl, and you can download the album. So however you like. I mean, people experience the music in different ways. I think the ultimate way to experience would be to get the vinyl.
Oh, yeah.
Because the vinyl comes with a download kit. So you get actually a bonus track of the vinyl.
Oh, nice.
And you get the full artwork and the insert and all kinds of cool pictures and stuff. So I would recommend getting the vinyl from cdbaby.com.
Sweet.
If you want to just stream the stuff, you know, not even pay for it, you can do that now on YouTube and stuff too, and Spotify and everywhere else.
Now, speaking of Spotify, because I have my music on there too. Have you ever seen any money come back from Spotify?
Oh yeah, it's awesome. When somebody streams the whole album, you get, I think, half a cent. It's great.
Oh damn.
So keep streaming, everybody. Keep streaming. We need about a million plays to make the money back for the album.
Do you guys go through Orchard or anything like that?
Probably. Because basically we used CD Baby for the distribution.
Okay.
And they just kind of push it to every platform that's out there if you want.
Oh, okay.
So that's what we did. So I think it's on Orchard and all the other sites I can't even follow. You
know? Yeah, there's a lot, man. Do you ever just like go do a Google search on your music and just see where crazy places are have your music posted at?
Yeah, it's insane. I mean, it shows up on, like, a week later, it shows up on like, a Russian blog. You know, it's great. That's the great thing about the internet.
Oh, man.
It just gets out there.
I like finding my stuff, like, on a Chinese Amazon site. I'm like, how the hell did it get on over there?
Yeah, I think that was the ultimate thing when the last album showed up at this shop, like, used in Japan, so they took a picture of it. We probably sold 10 albums over there, but it was like, that, you know, it reached the other side of the world.
That's
man.
Right.
That was the cool thing.
Okay, so I got the Return of the Spectral Rider. What song would you like me to play for everybody tonight? I played a bunch of them in the background, but I need something that could feature it. We did play Turn the Screw earlier.
Yeah, Turn the Screw is the song that we were pushing in the beginning, you know, when it first came out. So, let's see. Well, if you're looking for a short song, Ravage Part 1, Damage, is the fastest, shortest song on there. If you want to play something real long, then The King Forgotten is the epic track. And if you want to play something in between, then I'd say The Wasteland or Curse of Heaven.
Mm-hmm. I'll play the long one. I'll play the King Forgotten.
That's the epic one, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to play that one. If it gives me time to go make me some more Kahlua and come back and get in the mode again and then get scared by your talking in the song.
That thing
it really scared me. I'm like, what the fuck? I actually turned my shoulder. I thought somebody was behind me talking to me.
Well, that's the effect. And that song, we actually put like that Michael Jackson Thriller whispering effect in the beginning.
Did you?
So if you listen on headphones, there's a lot of cool stereo stuff in that song. Oh,
then maybe that's why, because I have the headphones on and I was listening to it like that.
Yeah, so it's supposed to be like somebody talking in your ear.
That's what it was.
Cool. Some creep.
Can you do us a quick favor?
Sure.
Can you do a promo ID for a radio show? Just say your name, the band you're with, you're listening to Maximum Threshold, and throw something crazy out at the end of it and don't put no thought into it.
Okay. Just tell me when to go.
Go.
This is Al from Ravage, and you're listening to Maximum Threshold. Yeah!
Okay, I'll go with that. You want to hear some? Want to hear some samples of the other ones that you did? I have to compare that one to.
I don't know what to compare that to.
Here, I'll play one for you. Listen to this one. Let's see.
Yo, this is Ace Frehley, and you're listening to Maximum Threshold Radio. I just came from outer space.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure Ace was very sober when he did that one.
He told me he was, but I didn't believe it at all. You know, he wasn't. Yeah. We kept asking him about the Kiss coffin. If he got automatically got one free, he's like, I don't want to answer that.
I know that.
Yeah, he was funny, man. We kept talking about his Dunkin' Donuts commercials.
Oh, I never seen that.
Oh man, you got to Google Ace Frehley Dunkin' Donuts. You got to watch it because, oh, it's hilarious. He actually does the commercial and he's got like fire and sparkles and shit fly out of his guitar and stuff. You got to watch it. It's short and it's funny. Okay, man, we're going to get going here, but I definitely thank you for coming on the show here and talking with us. And definitely we're going to do our part to get the word out there to everybody to, you know, get a hold of your music there and, you know, to buy your stuff. And you got... Do you have any merch on your website as well?
Yeah, we've got T-shirts now, pins, patches, you know, for those who have the metal vest.
Mm-hmm.
So, just go to our Facebook and message us for if you want anything. And we'd love to hear from you.
Cool. I'm definitely going to put all the links up there on the website. And we'll focus on your band there for a while on our site, too, so we could help and do our part, do what we got to do. Help you out.
Really appreciate it, man. Thanks for having us.
No
on
problem.
The show.
Hey, and once again, thanks a lot for being on our show tonight.
Yeah, no problem. Anytime.
Okay, man. Have yourself a good evening.
You too.
Okay. Bye. There you go, man. Hey, thanks, Al, for coming on the show here. Here you go. This is Ravage with the King Forgotten here on your Maximum Threshold Radio Show. Horns up, fist in the air, baby.
But just how much is in my hands? only to grasp the stones, to take the power, to live forever. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, this is Ron from YouTube's Rock and Metal News, and this is your Maximum Threshold Rock and Metal News report. Alter Bridge have released a music video for the song Cradle to the Grave on YouTube. It includes video from their O2 Arena in London performance. Stay tuned for the new live and rarities set live at the O2 Arena, plus rarities out through Napalm Records on September the 8th. And Brendan Small, who also plays in Death Clock, released the second track from his new album, Galacticon 2, Become the Storm. The song is My Name is Murder, which is on YouTube now. The album is out on August the 25th. And Rammstein have released pro video of the song Engel live on YouTube. It's from June the 4th, 2017 at the Rockheim Park Festival in Germany. So you can check that out. It's amazing footage. Continuing with your MaximumThreshold.net rock and metal news, Melvins are streaming a new track from their album A Walk with Love and Death, which is out July 7th. The song What's Wrong with You is now on YouTube, so you can check that out. And Tesseract have released a new song titled Smile, which they recorded earlier in 2017. It's out now as a digital single on digital retailers. And finally, Threat Signal's new album Disconnect is set for release in the fall. The band confirmed the album on Instagram during their post. They stated, "We are releasing our new album this fall. Release date is set. Promo in motion. More details soon." So stay tuned for any updates on the new Threat Signal. This is Ron from YouTube's Rock and Metal News with a Z, and this has been your Maximum Threshold Rock and Metal News Report. Thanks for tuning in.
That's right. Thanks, Ron, man, as always. Definitely thank you very much for doing that, man. We love you, man. You know, man, you're right here in my heart, man. You know that, man. Okay, I'm going to play this song, then we're going to come back. I got this interview that I did with John Cooper of Skillet. So we're going to play that. It's not that long. It's just a couple minutes. And then we're going to play some music by them. Then we're going to come back. And then we're getting out of here, man, so you guys can go do your thing. I think there's an MMA fight tonight, too. So I'm going to check it out. I'm not sure, but I hope so, because I want to see somebody get their fucking ass whipped. Here's some Alter Bridge. Cradle to the Grave, man. Ron was just talking about the song. Wait to hear my interview with these dudes I did a couple weeks ago, man. Hilarious. They wanted to beat my ass.
Don't ever let me go. From the cradle to
Ice-T. This is Dominic of Maximum Threshold Radio.
What's happening, man?
I just want to say, man, it's an honor to be here standing next to you. I got the new body count. I say it's fucking badass, man.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. I can't stop listening to that damn thing.
Yeah. Well, we're out here on Mayhem Fest promoting it. We just happen to have this stop through here in Cleveland, which is cool to do this. So it's a good day off the tour. But we're just out here cruising, you know, checking it out.
Bringing your babies with you?
Yeah, you know, I got to travel. I travel with my whole family.
That's right.
Son.
How you doing, man?
Spartacus, Maximus. Nice. Coco's out here every day. She missed today. She had to go home for a minute.
Gotcha. So how does it make you feel to be part of this AP Awards, the first ever one to have?
It's good to be able to bring Ernie out. Let him touch a red carpet now.
Right. Can you do me a quick favor?
Yeah.
Can you do a promo ID for a radio show?
Yeah, what's that?
Say your name. We're with Maximum Threshold Radio.
What?
Maximum Threshold Radio.
Hey, yo, ready? Yo, this Ice. Yo, this Ice-T and Ernie C from Body Count. Ready, go. This Ice-T
and Ernie C
from Body Count. You're listening to Maximum Threshold Radio. That's why the girls are screaming.
That's right.
Our request on MaximumThreshold.net.
I'll be back. Good to see you, man. Okay. Let's do it.
Hey, this is my time, man.
I know, right? Leave him alone.
Hey, this is Dominic of Maximum Threshold Radio, and I have before me...
Hey, John with Skillet.
Nice, man. How you doing, man?
Oh, man. I'm top of the world today.
I got to check you guys out as usual, man. I've seen you guys, about a dozen times already.
Probably so.
And every time I see you, it's the same ferocity you guys put out there, man.
Oh, thank you so much. I
love
appreciate that. Yeah.
I love your band is so tight, and you guys you bring it every show.
Oh, well, thank you so much. That's something I love to do. I love performing. And to me, it's about creating a moment in a show. It's passion for the music and what you believe, whatever you're singing about, whatever it may be, that you feel it and you want the crowd to feel it with you. And when you're all in that moment together, that to me, that's why we're here.
I hear you.
That's why we're here, baby. So every show needs to be like Kiss.
That's it. And it's very memorable, too. And I remember going back a couple years ago with you with Shinedown on the Cards of Madness thing. I remember seeing that. I've seen you in Cleveland so many times. And like I said, every single time, it's very memorable. And
well, thank you so much.
It is like a Kiss show. It's something you can't forget.
Wow, well, that's awesome. I appreciate it. Shout it out loud. I love Kiss.
I had an old friend who used to do like a podcast sort of thing years ago, and he turned me on to your guys' music. It was he played your music. It was a theme to his show. It was like probably about 7 years ago, and when I was upstairs watching you guys play, I saw it and it made me think of it because he died like 3 years ago.
Oh, wow.
So I went to his Facebook page and said, "Brian, man, we miss you, and I know you guys, you love this band, you know." He was such a positive person.
Right.
And so I posted a picture from you guys on there. But it made me think about him, so bring back good memories.
That's really cool to hear. Thank you, man.
So let's talk about your new one real quick.
Do it, baby.
So with this one you got, what makes this one, I know you're in this cliche, but what makes this one different than the last one?
Oh, yeah, and you mean the whole record,
yeah.
Right? Okay, yeah.
The whole vibe and everything.
You know, it's a good question because Skillet records are usually a little different, you know. This record's called Unleashed, and I called it Unleashed because... I didn't want to make the record... I'm looking around to make sure my label people aren't here.
Jason, got
over here. Good, we're good. I wanted to make a record not for my label, but for me. And that's not dissing them. It's just... Sometimes they want you to do something that I just don't want to do. And I don't think the fans like. So I said, you know what? I'm going to listen to what you say, but I'm not necessarily going to do what you say. And this is me off the leash. And that's why we called it Unleashed. And we had a great time making it. I think that it just made everything more fun, and I said, if I write a song and it doesn't say a whole lot and all it says is I feel it invincible, that's what we're going to say, because it's fun. And I think that it made the record, it gave good vibes on the record, and most of the fans have said there's something about this record that's just energetic, and people keep telling me it's inspiring or whatever they want to call it, and it was fun making it, so I think it kind of came on to the record in that way.
Gotcha. Just a couple things here, we'll let you get going. I know you're a busy guy in here today. So how can people get a hold of your new one?
Oh, gosh. Unleashed, of course, iTunes. You know, it's going to be in the very few stores that still sell music, I'm assuming. But probably the best place to find out all the information on Skillet, skillet.com. I know it's old school to go to a website. It's got Facebook links, Instagram links, Twitter. We've got video podcasts we put online that are really funny backstage stuff and hanging out doing dumb crap on the road. If you really want to see what road life's like, check out the podcast.
I'll definitely do that. Yeah. Can you do us a quick favor?
Yeah.
Can you do a promo ID for a radio show?
Oh, yeah.
Just say your name, the band you're with, you're listening to Maximum Threshold, and throw some crazy out at the end of it, and don't put
Maximum
no thought into
threshold.
It.
Maximum Threshold. Hey, it's John with Skillet. You're listening to Maximum Threshold. Hold, hold, hold.
Sweet.
The secret side of me, I never let you see. I keep a cage, but I can't control it. So stay away from me, the beast is ugly. I feel the rage and I just can't hold it. It's scratching on the walls, in the closet, in the halls. It comes awake and I can't control it. Hiding under the bed, in my body, in my head. Why won't somebody come and save me from this? Make it end. I feel it deep within, it's just beneath the skin. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I hate what I've become, the nightmare's just begun. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I feel like a monster. I feel like a monster. My secret side I keep, hid under lock and key. I keep a cage, but I can't control it. Cause if I let them out, tear me up, break me down. Why won't somebody come and save me from this? Make it in. I feel it deep within, it's just beneath the skin. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I hate what I've become, the nightmare's just begun. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I feel it deep within, it's just beneath the skin. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I feel like a monster. I feel like a monster. It's hiding in the dark, its teeth are razor sharp. There's no escape for me, it wants my soul, it wants my heart. No one can hear me scream, maybe it's just a dream. Maybe it's inside of me.
Like a monster.
I hate what I've become. The nightmare's just begun. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I feel it deep within. It's just beneath the skin. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I gotta lose control. It's something radical. I must confess that I feel like a monster. I feel like a monster. I feel like a monster.
Yeah, that's it, man. That was the interview that I did with John Cooper. And before that, you heard a little clip of a little interview I did with Ice-T and Ernie C and his dog. Coco wasn't with him. That was pretty cool. I only had like a minute with him. So you had to toss everything out there and fanboy out a little bit. And that's what I did. I did that just for you guys. Okay, well, I'm getting out of here, but I thank you again for joining us, man, just hanging out with us. And sorry the show is short, and it's a 2-hour show tonight, but I wanted to get this out there to you. We've been doing pre-records for the last month, and I wanted to get these live ones out to you. I know we missed an interview earlier in the program. Like I said, we had server problems. It wasn't me. It was the server itself is down. I guess there's storms going on somewhere in Indiana or wherever the hell this server's being hosted at or whatever, the website. So, like I said, thanks for tuning in. I appreciate you guys all tuning in. I'm going to update all our pages, all the sites. If you like the new MaximumThreshold.net site, shoot me a message over there and tell me what you think, what I should add to it, or whatever, man. If you got want a different background on there or something, let me know, and we'll try to make you happy. Also, if there's an artist that you want us to interview on the show here, pass it over to us, and I'll do what I can do, man. We've had over 800 interviews on the show so far. It's probably way over that, but I'm not counting them all. That's just the ones that I have, individual ones. So, yeah, I'm getting out of here, but I thank you again for tuning in this week. I want to thank, go check out these bands, man. Crown of Earth, Ravage. Get the new Body Count out, man. It's badass. And the new Skillet. Get your grubby little nubs on them and make them yours today. And definitely go to their website and buy their merch. You know, do it for them, man, because they put this music together for you. Also, please subscribe. And we're on Google Music, Google Play, whatever the hell that is. You can get us over there. You go to Apple Podcast. You can subscribe to the show. And if you subscribe to our show, please give us 5 stars as well as a little comment, positive comment about us. Just the good things you like about us. We've already seen all the bad stuff. You don't have to rub it in. We already know all that stuff. So who cares? So please do that. Thanks, everybody, again, for tuning in this week. And I'm glad I'm able to get on the mic here because it's my therapy with you guys. Wow. It's great, man. So I'm getting out of here. Thanks, man. I'm leaving on this note, man. The classic track of the night. Yeah, man. Yeah.
just listened to Maximum Threshold Radio Show. It is live every Saturday night, 8 p.m. until whenever the fuck they shut up. So tune in.
It is pointless to resist.